I said good day, sir!
Welcome back, everybody, here to our last game of the evening. Game number 2 of Alliance going up against Evil Geniuses. I was about to actually show you the game, but it looks like we'll have to have ourselves a very, very quick remake, as one of our modes, I believe, was incorrect. But either way, the game is starting off in a couple of minutes. I say a couple of minutes, like maybe 30 seconds. It gives time to say a very warm welcome to my co-commentator.
My Coco.
That's right.
Yes. You're very welcome now.
You're a wonderful beverage during winter. That's what you are, Wyga. What you are. But yeah, the game is being rehosted back up again, and we're getting ourselves back into the mix. But yeah, there was a small problem with the initial creation. Did you actually see what it was? Were we in all pick mode?
I didn't even see. They just left very, very early. But I don't know. Probably, you know, something. Doesn't really matter what it is.
Doesn't.
Just get a quick remake and... Seems that we might have to wait a little bit. Come on, EG.
Yeah, hoping everybody gets everyone back inside the game. Benny is hosting. We're just waiting for our last EG player to get back in again. Just a reminder too, guys, while you're chilling around, because we had a moment for our PR announcement before, remember you can pick up the Dota TV ticket for the defense over in the Steam online store. You can find the links from the joinDOTA website as well. They're actually included in every single game in the match ticker, so you can find them out there. And you can also subscribe to the channel. If you want to subscribe to the Twitch TV channel, it means you don't have to watch ads, but you still can contribute. Get the word right first time. It's been a very long 2-3 days, man.
It's been long.
Yeah, it's been long, but it's been great Dota. It's been great Dota. The pain is worth it. The pain is worth it, man.
It sounds like
you're tapping the mic, man.
Oh yeah?
Yep. Sounds like you're not anymore. You're good now.
Okay. Yeah, should be fine.
Yeah. Fantastic. Fantastic.
Anyway.
This time we load in, this time we're in captain's mode, this time everyone appears to be happy.
Everything should be fine.
Yep. And let's see if the Bat Rider this time around gets banned out.
Yeah. I mean, I would expect it now from Alliance, but on the other hand, they have the first pick, I believe, so they could just choose to go for it instead.
Well, you are right, they do have the first pick up. Remember, because it does change around a little bit in the later version, in the later point. So the second pick phase, actually, the first pick belongs to Fear. In that scenario,
it is a little bit different. You have to think about that when you want to get your heroes and which order you have to draft them. So we'll probably see some changes. At least they will ban out the Nyx. They did not enjoy the double roam combo, at least from Nyx, along with the Batrider when they had their items.
Well, Nyx out. Fear, what do you got in store for us, man? Team's taking their sweet-ass time, and he takes out the Lone Druid. So Bulldog won't get his signature hero in this game. But it does mean, I highly doubt the Wisp will get through, but Wisp and Batrider are both in the pool. Does somebody really want to play with a fire? I wonder if S4 wants to play with a full fire, and he bans out something else in this set.
Ban out a Meepo or something, and just see what happens. we'll see. It's surprising to see... Wisp not being removed, but of course, these are respect bans for last game where Fear did an amazing job with the Nyx, and of course, removing the Lone Druid, I would not blame anyone. But I am interested to see how much the Lone Druid change would actually affect Bulldog's offlane Lone Druid, because you don't want to die even once with your bear.
He's going to do it. Does Fear still ban out the Wisp, or does he say, you know what, Wisp for a Batrider is a worthy trade?
I would expect him to actually leave both. If he bans one, he's still going to have to play against the other. Remaining. He might just go ahead and ban out something else, but we'll see what he opts to do. With the Darks, he ban out. Yeah, he leaves both. Furion's still a very good ban, and he manages to limit Bulldog even more. So they might want to go for a Clockwork again now due to this.
Would you still want to do the Clockwork when you're going to go for a Wisp pickup?
Well, we'll see.
And also, just to note too, because I was getting information, because obviously we've also got to get used to this new patch.
Exactly, the cogs don't affect the magic immune targets anymore.
Yeah, and that was the reason why Bulldog was popping the cogs all the time very early on.
Still, he could, like, on the top gank on and many other the other ones, he could hook, walk past, and then cog. That is something that you have the time to do with the stun duration, and it's really effective. So I'm surprised that he didn't try to do that a single time, but indeed, he can't push and cancel the TP when the spin started. At that point, they have nothing.
I'm interested to see what combination Alliance want to use with this Wisp, because most people would instantly just say, well, it'll be CK. Well, CK would be the instant obvious one to go. But I'm wondering if Alliance just prefer to go for the tiny above the CK, or maybe even try their older combination, which was Wisp and the Self-Assassin together. It might be very dependent on what EG is going to be picking up. And the Wisp SA didn't work too well.
I think they will very much just adapt to their enemies with this. You can play Wisp Tiny, you can play Wisp, you know, even Wisp Ursa. There's so many things that you can do. Mm-hmm. It just depends on what does the enemy have and how do you adapt.
Level 1 Roshan, bring it on, peoples. Bring it on.
Yeah. Alliance, known for that.
EG gets stable pickups for their two. Keeper of the Light and Batrider gives so many options again. We'll see if Batrider again remains in the middle lane. Or it might even be a possibility that... I don't know if Bamboo... if he wants to take up the role as Batrider. And Alliance should go with the Magnus. So we're going to focus a little bit more on Teamfighter Hero. Well, Magnus, we don't normally see
anymore. The thing is with Magnus, they open up to go for the PA, for the Void, for any type of melee carry. And when you play Wisp, a melee carry is what you want. And it just makes that hero so much stronger in the mid-late game. 5 seconds remaining. So it makes perfect sense that they pick it up. But with the new change to the pick phase, they don't really have, you know, their third pick is a little bit later due to the bans coming up now. Mm. So,
it's also a nice insurance in case they do, like, as you said, like, with PAs, like, if that PL comes away of fear. But they can always just ban out the PL. If they don't want to go up against that, Gyro is also still in the pool too. Another hero which has been slightly overlooked in this draft.
Yeah. It's a lot harder to draft Caudal PL in this game, by the way. In this mode. Because you only have two picks in the first stage, and then you have to wait for the bans. Mm-hmm. And their PL will be banned a lot if you pick up the Caudal. And you don't really want to start out picking Caudal PL as your first two picks, and then have the bans come out, because the enemy can adapt too much against you. So I feel it's a little bit harder. And it just kind of remove the most standard.
So take him out anyway. Well, if you can't ban out against anything else, because the mid lane's already there, support's there, you probably already feel confident enough against banning off against most of the off laners that Alliance would use anyway. Clockwork at this point in the game may be exactly what you are searching for.
Yeah, I really like the Lifestealer ban by Alliance. This Lifestealer is such a hero that can survive the Wisp TP pretty well. Mm-hmm. And you want to have as few heroes as possible on the enemy team that can survive the TP. That's when you really force the enemy to go 5-man DOTA very early. And that's what, you know, one of the games where Alliance played against LGD, I believe, they had good reaction towards the Wisp. As soon as, you know, they had to go 5, they did go 5. But you get really shut down if you have to walk as 5 very early on in the game. Mm-hmm. So just bringing your enemy to that state, but not removing the PL, though.
No, they take out the clockwork. They've really shut down that long lane. This almost forces Magnus to go long lane.
The other way around, I feel that Alliance could have banned out the PL, but they did not, so there is the option. But PL against the Wisp is also scary.
Yeah. You have Wisp anywhere on the map that can just bring dust with him and you're in trouble. SD's going to be the selection.
Yeah, I like this. Really, it's a really nice pick. They can stand behind carries or solo laners and just prepare for a counter gank.
Well, we got Arceus Chem. So it will be a defensive lane from Alliance.
It really looks like one of those PA games from Alliance where they will just farm up in the early game.
But still, what happens with their other lanes now? Do they just sack the bottom and grab themselves another hero into the jungle? Because you've already got a Chen and a Wisp. So Chen doesn't want to leave the jungle and doesn't want to kind of like share the jungle.
I think they just kind of throw any solo hero down to the bottom lane, but I'm not sure who they want to go there.
They could go with an older one of Admiral Bulldog, which is the Bounty Hunter. That's the last one which really comes to mind as far as his off lane goes.
It's a very low impact hero in fights, but yeah, actually going to be a Bounty Hunter. It's very good if you can get the kills with the Wisp, and you will obviously snowball like crazy. But we'll see how much he can actually get done here.
Well, the Bounty Hunter will be, like, it's like kills with the Wisp, because obviously Bounty Hunter will give you the track.
Yeah,
like, most of the time, the strength of a Wisp is judged on the strength of the wards and the combo. If the wards are aggressive, you get the vision on these heroes, you can go and find some kills. You always find them inside the jungle when you're least expecting it. But a Bounty Hunter walks around invis, don't even need the track at the very, very start. But the second that track goes off, and then you bring in the support, that's three heroes that are involved in a track kill. And that just instantly, like, shoots your gold up. And Fear, yeah, he's worried about it. He takes out the PA, and Alliance, I wouldn't be surprised if it's just a tree as their last one. The tree is almost like the obvious last pickup for them. Unless we see something unusual, could be another option. Like, what if we actually look at, like, an Alchemist and say, you know what, let's just go a curveball here. You've always been worried about the ganking that's coming off from, like, the CK and the PA. What if we leave Alchemist farming, Wisp ulti's in, and the concoction's already channeled up a high amount? Might be another option for Alliance.
It could be, but we'll see how it actually, what they actually choose to go for. It's one of the things you could do, but how are they gonna, they could put in mid for sure. It's a lot of teams just put a solo mid Alchemist, especially in the Asian scene, and just farm up early mech on him. But I don't know. I feel the Batrider might want the mid this game. I'm not sure.
Well, if Batrider wants the mid, it's going to be difficult for EG.
We'll see.
I guess a trial for EG would be very, very nice, wouldn't it?
Because they played really well when Batrider got his farm in the last game. But then he was safe lane. And they could still be going aggressive with this for sure. Like, with a Caudle, ST, and Gyro, you can walk up and contest, but the dangerous part is Chen. If he comes in with Tornadoes, or if he gets early level 5 and then comes in, then you have to do something.
I'm actually waiting for Gyro on the bottom lane and Lunar on the top.
Yeah.
Just to throw it out there, they can run more aggressive. But then again, I don't know Bamboo.
I would prefer the Luna on bottom farming and Gyro in the fighting position then, though. Because Luna is very squishy on Trilane against Trilane.
But Luna up against a Bounty Hunter. If Bounty Hunter gets, like, an early orb, and he can harass Luna around that lane. Will be my biggest concern.
But she will control the farm. Her damage is very high, so Luna against Bounty Hunter should be pretty fine. But we'll see what they go for. They do go for the Alchemist.
Yeah, but this...
You're really following the picks this game.
This was on the other side, though. I was wondering if Alliance were going to combine it up with the Wisp. But right here, wrong team.
They do it the other way around, man. They predict the Wisp TP and then start channeling. Or even when they hear the Wisp TP, start channeling instantly.
Well, it's still an aggressive try lane. Alchemist with the concoction combining up with the SD disruption. Heroes like Wisp are going to have a hard time. Like, even if you do manage to tether yourself away, that hero is on the top lane that's supposed to be supporting for Alliance needs to be strong. But yeah. Tiny is still the obvious last one, but he can't keep fighting on the top lane. He throws out one stun and he basically is dry.
Yeah, Tiny is not too good here. Looking at the EG's lineup, it is going to be an Alchemist just standing down there on bottom, most likely in farming. He could be on the tri lane for sure, and Gyro solo. It kind of comes down to preference, what you want. I actually believe that the Alchemist would be stronger on the tri-lane. He will kill more.
Yeah. And Ricky Mario, they are...
Ricky Mario. So they're just going to play it safe. If it's tri against tri, or duel against tri, I should say, they're just going to try and play it really safe and most likely get up Chen to level 5, I would guess.
It's going to be difficult, though, man. Like, I haven't seen a single Wisp Ricky Mario game of Alliance actually work.
it's good in theory. No, but...
The theory is definitely kind of like where it ends. Like, theory is most definitely it.
We haven't seen it that much.
I actually remember because I was having a chat to Loader about this at the last Style Ladder Finals, and I said, like, man, Wisp and Ricky, like, do you really think it works? He's like, yeah, we get enough momentum up on the Ricky, and nothing would stop it. And I'm like, okay, fair enough.
Well, Wisp and anything, enough momentum, nothing can stop it. That's the idea of Wisp.
Yeah, but the problem is Ricky's going to die so quickly. And you're going up against the Keeper of the Light, SD, and Alchemist. If they catch him out once, even with the blink away, Ricky Morrow's going to lose a lot of life. And I'm wondering if this almost forces them to run aggressive with this lane. Switch it up.
Yeah, they are. His work cut out for him, pretty much.
They're all running down south. I'm seeing smoke up on these heroes. Observer wards up on EGM. And look who's heading towards the top lane. S4 is, in fact, going to solo up the top lane. This could run Ricky and Wisp in the middle lane, Bounty long lane, RK, and as in the jungle.
No, this works much better for them if they do this. they're just going to do all that.
It's a slight bottle bill for Magnus. It's still a slight bottle bill for Magnus.
Yeah, Magnus is not going to be too happy, but he is S4. He's son of Magnus. He'll be fine.
But his escape mechanism on this top lane is not going to be great.
Oh, he's checking out what's going on. And the entire team of EG coming up here showing that they want to be aggressive. Mm-hmm. And just going to maybe try and stun here. Very far. He's not going to go for that.
He can't keep up with him, man.
He's just zoning them out.
He's got an amazing movement speed, which is nothing. 295 movement speed. The only person he can keep up in a walking battle is EGM. And EGM has tether. Technically, he doesn't walk. He hovers. And, okay, so this... Why, what? Okay, Alliance, make up your mind. S4 is now going to come into the middle lane. Wisp almost looked like he wanted to be with him. And well, it will be a defensive try lane with Bounty on the long. And he'll be going up against Geo as the
gyro.
They're
going to switch to Bounty Hunter, I guess. Loda and Wisp will run down bottom and Bounty is running top. And they are not ready for this. EG, that is. They're not completely ready for the switch. But they're going to know. Since they don't see anyone at this point, they will know that the switch is coming.
They're already coming up. I'm wondering how many wards get placed here. Because Beat is, he plants down a sentry ward. Of course, remember the changes to the observer wards as well. That you got to use sentry wards and a block the cancer because you only get one set of observer wards at the front. Bambi just got blocked there by Bulldog. In fact, he's blocking the path up. EG can't get there.
He's very cheeky.
He holds him out a little bit longer, which means EG's tri lane misses out a little bit. And Fear and Beat is instantly just say, screw this. We're coming middle lane. S4, he just got his second point. And very luckily so, he should be skilling up his skewer right now because we've already got support coming for him. He turns around. He's trying to skewer. Oh, you can see him prep the skewer. He wanted to pull Beaters up and towards the tower because then he might have a chance. Tether's now going to come in from EGM, and there's the skewer only picking up an illusion. Luckily,
Shed
EGM.
The centaur, but not going to really do anything yet.
And you talk about momentum with Loda while all these supports are rotating around. Hang on, there's concoction on Demon. He's waiting as long as possible to stun up S4 there. But there's no follow through. Maybe with the Keeper of the Light Blast, it would have been enough.
Chen. Oh, look at ST.
I like this. Tether stun to start with. There he goes. Actually, the tether stun broke. The tether wore off at the last moment. The Keeper of the Light Blast. Actually, the disruption saves EGM from the damage. And concoction again from Demon. He's not close enough to anybody. Maybe Akka. No, he's not. Fear's going to go down here. One more attack. There it comes from the Chen. And First Blood goes to Alliance, who are now going to come down for Geo. Goes into his battery, into his rocket barrage. RK, not enough damage on him to stop him. And the Centaur, it's got another stomp.
Well.
Yeah, you know he wants to kill an RK.
He wants blood, but he's not too strong.
Especially when RK is able to play around.
Be careful if the micro is correct here from RK. Oh my god.
Of course it's correct, man. Of course it's correct. Chen gets the kill, another tether stone through, and EG's bottom lane is not working.
Yeah.
And in the meantime,
just
too,
making play here.
Check the farm of Loda. Because Gyro went
doing
out.
Amazing against this Gyro. I don't understand. It's 1-0 Gyro. He did go out to fight, but even before he went out to fight. And we see another pickoff actually top lane now.
Aggressive Bamboo.
Yeah, Bamboo showing that he should be winning this lane, and he does win it.
Look at this Wisp. Man fighting up against EG, and he has to tether himself away to safety. He's still going to salve available. I think he wants to take the damage, so he's going to heal RK up all the way. But he's going to wait this out a little bit longer. Now keep it light blast. He has to pop the salve prematurely. Only way to survive there.
Yeah. And of course, Keeper of Light knew that. He just forced him to waste his salve. So just being annoying. But this farm on Loda is ridiculous for being on offlane here.
A 1-0 up against a 19-6, man.
Yeah, it shows how defensive J.O. had to play because they didn't have any wards down there. Mm-hmm. That's why he didn't want to show. There was no vision, so he didn't want to get picked off. But instead, he's really, really, really behind in farm. He has one CS.
And not to mention the fact that Loda, like, even look at the level difference. The fact that Loda is already up to 4 levels and almost 3/4 there.
Yeah, he's going to be scary in this game. So much solo EXP
as
well.
He's just coming over. There's like level 1 heroes here, and he's got like a 1-point cloud, 2-point backstab, 1-point blink. If either of these support heroes try and contest him going for the centaur, they'll die. And Fear, he tried to come in close. He'll have to disrupt himself if he wants to live. There goes the smoke up, so no disruption. One more attack from Loda. Oh, the tether stun helps him off. And now Geo, the damage was actually like split between EGM and Loda, and Loda's going to get himself a kill on the bottom lane. Whisper took the first one. Fear's even taking damage from the Wisp Spirits. There's a tether down to RK.
And Caudle is zoned out by Aki as well.
Wow.
They just killed three heroes like nothing.
How is this lane even working this way? It shouldn't work this way.
It's Aki mostly making it work along with EGM. Oh, wow. EGM.
Poison. It got him. Fear gets a snipe. Fear gets a snipe. Finally, there is revenge on the bottom lane for EG.
Very good snipe by Fear. He was... he saw this drive-by by Wisp and like, no. Loda, maybe a little bit far out this time.
Disruption for him, and there's nothing really to blink to. He's got to blink actually deeper into the Radiant side, and that means the beaters will be here waiting for him. Already two poison stacks up on him. Fear is out of mana, but he's got three poison up on him, and that means with Illuminate Blast, Loda probably should have run up a little bit higher. He's going to live because he's got stick charges, doesn't he? Yeah. And then when Wisp spirits him from the side, but he can't get through the creep wave.
Yeah, he has Blink Strike ready now again if he wants to go on someone. And Wisp can tether in, so...
I think Wisp also wants to keep his distance here. He should be keeping his distance. Loda's about to pop level 6. And these kind of like dives are going to be so much easier.
Mid lane, just being a nuisance now, Aki, moving around. This is more of a battle Chen than anything else. He's not farming. He's just making sure that everything else dies. He's free 0-0 already.
See the build on Alchemist too. Like, normally you'd say, okay, well, he's 25 for 5 on the CS. It should be looking good. But it's a battle Alchemist as well. He's gone 3-point spray, 2-point concoction, which, funnily enough, was also the build that Loda was playing around with during a couple of games during the Rakel EMS.
He doesn't have mana. This could be dangerous. He will get mana by a Magic Sick charge one more.
Yeah, but the problem is he's going to get it clamped and nuked, and that's too much damage. Bounty Hunter takes the kill, and that's with track bonus.
That's a track bonus, yeah. So, again, another kill by Aki's hands.
Demon. Skewer's going to pull him in range of the tower. He probably thinks he's fine because of Chemical Rage, but look at S4. He turns, RPs, drags him back, and with a double damage, he should have enough, and there's one more attack from S4. There it is.
Wow, really making so much.
And now bottom lane. Geo is inside the smoke. Sentry walls will drop down so they can at least see Loda, but he initiates at level 6 and then straight down to beaters.
Alliance, man, they're showing EG that they're not happy after the last game. They're just killing people everywhere now. This has already gone really out of control. EG need to go into panic mode and do something. They need to start fighting with Alchemist or just find kills with Batrider because things are not working. They have a level 3 carry.
You're also saying like find kills with Alchemist, but Alchemist at this point can't even stand up against one hero in the middle lane.
Yeah, but Bamboo
wants the top. Loda just TP top. The track up on him. They're trying to go on Bamboo into the Firefly. Flamebreak will keep him away. Shuritoss stuns him up. Loda, he actually has enough damage. He has enough damage when he's only walking around with Trez, but Batrider has Tranquils and a stick, and that's it.
Oh, it's a ridiculously strong hero when you max out. They do get a kill on EGM, who's solo, you know, fighting down here.
He solo bottom lane. Oh, he actually used his ulti as well, didn't he?
Yeah, I think he got put down his ulti, because he died.
Mm.
I didn't really see it go down, but...
No, I was watching the kill on the top lane instead.
But with, as you mentioned, the damage of Loda is enough. Yeah, with Treads and 4 points into backstab on Stealth Assassin, you're actually really, really strong. Your damage output is so high.
There's a gank on middle lane being attempted. Admiral Bulldog is here in Viz, and he just opens up on Demon a little bit. Just attacks him, throws the track out, and says, Demon, just make sure you're aware that I exist on this map.
Yeah, just putting some fear into him.
While Loda takes the T1 tower on top lane, or at least does some kind of damage to it. This Diffusal Blade is going to be so quick up on a Rikimaru. And he's getting solo experience while he's up on the top lane. Concoction attempted here by Demon.
Well, yeah. When you're tracked, it's hard to surprise someone. He's trying to be sneaky, but with track on him, it's just not working out that way.
At least it wears off now.
At least they tried to make something there. Because right as I said that they need to make something happen, Alliance actually shift up their main carry to the lane of Gondar and find a kill of their own. That's what I mean they need to do. They need to use the Batrider and their Alchemist, even if it's not ready yet. Mm-hmm. They need to start doing it.
S4's got himself an invis, yeah. He's looking around. And Demon, he can't stay close to this lane. On the bright side, well, I say a bright side for EG. Look at Geo. There's no one on this bottom lane for Alliance, but he's got up against a Bounty Hunter and a Rikimaru and a Wisp who's got an ulti.
He's just, you know, he knows that no one, even with Fear pinging him down, no one can save his life if they go on him. So Loda is pretty low on HP, actually, or on the top lane.
Demon just TP top. They're waiting for him. There's an Observer Ward from the Alliance just waiting for him to come out. Yeah. And that's why Bulldog's the first one out. Demon.
They're gonna go now.
Yeah, he's up too far. He crossed that tree line. RP, if you're gonna be used. He's gonna try and concoct the old die.
Triple stun.
Yep. Last gift of Demon to the world.
True. The stun actually goes off even if you get killed now.
Yep. And AoEs as well.
Yeah.
Now, that was actually done in two patches ago, though, I think. It wasn't done...
The fact that it goes off if you die?
Yeah. Yeah, okay. That was the patch before 6.78.
Yeah.
Oh, S4.
They see BDS running toward... Are they
I'm hearing a Wisp ulti. Yeah, they are. And it's going to be Geo. He'll go down, tracked up as well. And that's four heroes being involved in this kill. Skewer down, not worth an RP. Fear goes into the disruption.
Are they going to track him first?
They need time.
No.
1 second was required for Admiral Ball. I'd be like, man,
just says no.
Deny the monies. Why are you denying the monies?
He doesn't want money for other people. Takes the kill.
EGN's about to tether into the middle lane. He's going to combine up here with Arke. And Beat is, well, there's a whole bunch of spirits and a Chen Nuke, and that does a lot of damage. Demon, he wants EGM.
Are you stuck?
He's out. There's a small gap, but now with Bamboo there, he won't get himself away. The tether was already used.
To chase. Arke is going down here to... J.O. chasing him.
He doesn't have a hand. He's got seven stick charges and a centaur behind him. And now in comes S4.
He's running.
Concoction's already preparing from Demon. He wants to fight this one. Then the track reveals off the fact. And centaur can move back. Hold on, Demon. Hell there. The support coming in. Skewer. S4 right in the mix. He gets flame break back a little bit further away from Bamboo, but Bulldog comes in. Picks off the gyro. Now they'll move over to Demon. He is track gold if they can kill him off the centaur. Demon concocts himself. Nope. He actually does go down.
That
to the hands
when
of Alliance.
You are track gold.
Oh, Bamboo. No, he needs help. EGM attempted it. The one last track went off on Bamboo, and S4's in the neighborhood.
Yeah.
He's got RP in 5 seconds. He didn't have it for that entire fight.
EG got some kills out of this in the end, but it's just that they're falling so far behind because of all this. The kills that Alliance get are worth so much more, even being higher level. Sang and Yasha is finished up, so no defusal, just a Sang and Yasha.
Loda will never give up on this SMY belt.
Oh, he likes SMY. Mm. Good item.
But he loves it more than any of the other carry players in the EU scene.
That's true, but it does give him a very high max HP, and he is ridiculously fast now with track and tether. He's going to be pretty much max movement speed all the time. Mm. Into fights.
Well, he's gonna come top lane and see if he can combine it with S4. S4, who has nothing in his bottle at the moment, might be praying for regeneration at the 12-minute mark, which is like 7 seconds away. So he'll give her a shot. Look at his life points. Either he gets a regenerator or he goes back. He finds an invis.
He's gonna be like, I'll take it, but I'll go back. Oh, actually, he has his RP. Maybe he wants to use that before he backs. Yeah. We'll see. He is greedy. They did see him take it, though.
They're going for it, man.
Look at Loda. He finds the chicken. Chicken! Oh, he can't get it.
Could have got chick kills. Rocket, track now up on Geo. And there's a sentry wall for the Radiant side. And S4 realizes that when he's invis and he gets that on him, and then in comes Loda. Three hits to kill off Beaters at the back lines. Disruption from Fear.
Now he's a little bit in trouble. He's going to run. Look at how fast he is, though.
Yep. There's track up. That's the reason why. It's over on Geo, as well as on Demon. Admiral Bulldog just racking
their
it up.
Own tower.
Oh, there's a jump in. Smoke goes up on Geo and the Shuri Toss kills him off. And then another track over towards Fear. S4 is looking for a kill. Fear, a lot of damage. Admiral Bulldog can keep chasing this one down. Is that an RP that's already popped off? Yeah, it is. Bamboo, low life, Hand of God. Keeps him alive a little bit longer, but only a little bit. Over to the right.
Run, run.
Run where? Wisp is going to ulti in front. He's going to try and concoct this one up. Stun from the... Oh, he got smoked up. He can't even throw it.
This game got really hard very quick.
I think this game was hard from the start. 13-minute GG! 13 minutes, 15 seconds. Is this even a faster GG than the Team Empire game? This
I'm
may be
sure.
Our fastest GG in Defense 4 history.
Yeah, this game was pretty much decided from the start, actually. Really smart laning by Alliance.
Well, the second they shifted that lane down to be in a greater tri lane, and even though it wasn't even in the tri lane itself, it wasn't in the matchup.
It was just the fact that they were there, and the enemy did not, EG did not have defensive wards.
Yep.
So, because of this, JO had to play very careful. He didn't want to get caught out by the Chen. He expected that gank. But it was not there. The gank was not around him. But he just had to play so careful, and all the farm went the way of Lota.
Demon's trying to go for one last stand. He's the only one left inside the game, and Admiral Bulldog. He is definitely fixed on Demon's demise. And he will take him. And there goes Demon out from the game.
Yeah. And that's game.
Yeah, that it is, man. So Alliance, even in the matchup though, EG should still be very, very happy they managed to take a game off Alliance. It goes 1-1 in their matchup. So yeah. Alliance in this tournament so far are actually 1-2 in their results, and EG go 1-1. So EG locked themselves up with both Z-Rage in that, well, it will be a second position. And sitting in third will be the rest of them. It's just, yeah.
When is the next defense game?
Next defense game, man, tomorrow. Next defense game is tomorrow, and it's EG. They have a matchup against another Swedish team. They're in the pool of the Swedes at 18 CEST. That game will be happening. Liquid will then have themselves a doubleheader as well. They'll play up against the Peruvians as well as the Danish.
Oh, so, that's interesting. So Liquid just recently played a support Spirit Breaker game, by the way. Did you see that?
I did not see that, but...
Fluff played a support Spirit Breaker. It worked.
You'll have to leave me the results for it, man. You'll have to leave me the replay for it. Anyway, guys, we're going to wrap up tonight, and everyone get yourself some good rest. We'll see you all again tomorrow, 18 CEST starting time, unless there's any kind of change. But, of course, as always, keep your eyes on the countdown over on joinDOTA.com. That's where the details are. And also, make sure you follow Wagamama. Make sure you follow Wagamama. You're not the captain, are you? Or are you the captain again now?
Well, right now, you know, we don't have a five-man roster, but we'll... You can call me captain.
Yes. I can call you captain. I'm glad I can call you captain, Waga. I'm glad I can call you captain. All right. Follow him over on... Actually, is it Waga Dota?
Waga Gaming.
Waga Gaming. Waga Gaming. That's the place to go on Twitter.
Anyway, thanks for having me. It was fun casting.
It's been beautiful, man. It's been beautiful. All right, guys. We'll see you all tomorrow, 18 CST. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you then. Rebroadcast coming up in like 10 minutes or so. Later.
I said good day, sir!